changes influence team fight so significantly. But actually, the hover is changed at the last second, and Loken going to be falling back on the Caitlyn pick.
This was actually something that he did.
And I think that might have been the difference maker on Hacker not being able to get away.
Well, they do have curves coming across as well, but Kanavi's in a pretty decent spot. There's a flag
and
drag.
Oh, beautiful flash from Hacker, but Kanavi matches it with a flash of his own. There's first blood.
When you can, Hacker's come down to the bottom lane, and he's found Loken already challenging. Smite goes down. Flash from Loken will keep him alive.
I'm going to see the same on the top side, though.
Another flash coming on through. Curse going to try and turn things onto Kanavi here, but I don't think he has the damage, and Zoom grabs.
Definitely a trade that goes the way of OMG right now. That
to be going in towards the top side of the map, trying to get on towards the Ornn, but Hacker is hovering mid. Lumel is there.
Icon going to be rooted on up here, forced on back, and well, that's going to be a kill for sure. Icon goes down. And
which is going to be... try to get Miguel and Zoom rolling so that we can make plays like this.
Here we go. Big damage coming on through. Goes golden, but SMLZ now trying to run away for himself. Loken gets the kill onto Cold with the ace in the hole.
Hacker and Cold blocking for the squishies on the team. Rift Herald down to 2,000 HP. Lumao gets onto Cold. There's going to be a knock-up onto the back line of Loken there.
In the meantime, Zoom taking a bit of damage. Loken gets away from Hacker's ultimate. SMLZ trying to finish the job. It's one kill
towards this dragon. That's going to even the dragons up. It's an ocean for a cloud.
We'll find out what the soul is going to be.
Just finish this tower off for themselves. And that's a good chunk of gold that will go into their pockets. No answer available across the map.
For JDG, and then they can start to retreat up, but maybe they just find the pick instead.
Yeah, they've managed to find Hacker with his
Hacker has just been spotted on a ward, so there's not going to be too much coming from this. Although OMG, at least with the pressure curse, has been
on the map, and this is the moment. SMLZ could make magic happen here if he can land a huge Moonlight Vigil. It's just going to be one kill, though, because Hacker gets caught out away from his team. He's gone, but OMG are pushing on in. Look at that line of traps coming out from Loken. It makes it so difficult to contest. Hacker's there, and he will get the steal with an auto attack. Zoom the first targets. Hacker jumps straight onto the back line, but he's gone way too deep. Goes golden and keeps himself alive. Kanavi now the next target. Lamb's Respite keeps them all breathing for now. Kanavi flashes away, and it's another kill for Loken. Cold goes down as Loken goes Super Saiyan. Curse now trying to do anything in this situation, but there's nothing he can do. Kanavi gets the kill, and that's an ace.
He was caught out in a position where he really didn't want to be in. With the Cassiopeia down, SMLZ was next to be jumped on by.
So anyways, I started blasting, just like annihilates the entire team, and they're just going to be more than happy. And that is like perfect situation. Here we go, big fight coming on out as Curse gets locked on up. Hacker will go down as Loken just chunks them out, and that's a nice easy kill for the side JDG. But I mean, what a way to blow this game open. This is basically even. They start an Infernal Drake. Sure, they lose that objective, but not only do they get an ace, they get a Baron on top of it. This was more than they could have wanted out of that fight.
Oh yeah, and now they're able to power through this mid lane as well. You've just picked off Hacker, so the big engage tool that we were looking at is out of the picture. So Loken stepping forward, commanding space with Kanavi. That's two towers. We might take a third, although Hacker will be up in just a few moments.
Well, we can see Loken. He has his three items, and he just got an upgraded Infinity Edge as well. This is a terrifying Caitlyn as Yagao splits in the bottom lane. These headshots are going to just about one-shot squishy targets. And we were questioning whether Loken, what he was going to be able to do coming back onto this roster for JDG. We were questioning whether the Demacia Cup results would translate. So far they are. Cold is going to be the target. Kanavi. It's going to be knocked up here. Jumps on back. Huge cataclysm, but Lamb's Respite keeps everyone alive for now. Huge amount of AoE going across the board. But so far, trading one for one. Hacker the next target as he jumps on in. The Infernum not doing enough damage. Yagao's clone goes down, but it's traded for an entire team. OMG fall, and JDG will take their first game of the LPL in style.
And this was not convincing from OMG. Tried to make the big plays, but it just never really worked out for them.
Looking for JDG is going to be that Lee Sin going towards Kanavi in the jungle. Deciding to go away from the Kindred this time. Doesn't want to try and skirmish against
the issue just yet. Hacker
is going to spot the situation. Goes for a stun, and there's a follow-up coming out from Cold. Kanavi flashes away, but the Ignite is ticking, and that's a kill going the way.
Find the right situation. Rift Herald can still be an incredibly strong objective. It's just...
walking his way over towards the Cloud Drake while Zoom goes on to the top side.
The Flash Flight comes through from Cold here, but immediate counter engage going down. But the kick onto Hacker will keep him alive for now. Dodges the bullet time with the rappel, but there goes Zoom. Gets an obliterate. It's two kills on the other side for Icon, though. He's going crazy as Loken shuts him down. In the end, Zoom once again on the back line. SMLZ falls. It's another kill going the way of Loken here, and Curse finds himself alone. OMG, once again, lose the 5v5.
Fantastic decision.
Basically a 4v2. He can comfortably do that on this Mordekaiser. He's only going to get stronger as well. Phenomenal stuff coming out from Zoom here. And we're consistently seeing these Mordekaiser top players being able to do so much to sway the game.
Well, we are going to see the Dragon being gifted over towards OMG as JDG decide they want to go for the Rift Herald.
Maybe not quite. One or two autos will do it. There's the love tap just to finish the job off. With four members here, they might look to push a little bit further than just the tier one here. They might look to get a charge.
Wrapping around.
Look for the dive, or maybe just look for the turret. There's the charge from the Herald and a comfortable tier.
Another Dragon for themselves. So 2-1 at the moment, but you can see again, OMG, it's a lot more difficult when you're not in control of the game.
Luke Mao just missed his Zenith Blade on a standing still target. Cold walks away, Call of the Forge God going to disengage this fight. In the meantime, we've got a kill from Hacker going in onto Yagao. They're going to turn this into a bigger fight. Bullet time onto everyone. Curse, the next target, who's going to flash over the walls. Kanavi finishes. JDG have complete control of the mid lane, and that's going to reward them with this tier 1 tower. Hacker doing what he can, but
the cocoon, a wild hook coming your direction. So they want to try and make sure that they are taking this
the
nice
waters to see if the Baron's happening. Important to mention, there is a Scryer's Orb in the Baron pit for the side of OMG. So they knew the Baron was a start. Bullet time comes on in, Call of the Forge God, but Cold goes down first. Vanguard's Edge doesn't do too much for the likes of Icon, as Curse will go gold and keep himself alive, but Icon's been found out all alone in the back. Realm of Death will end. Icon keeps himself alive for now. Not a huge amount coming out from the Moonlight Vigil.
And JDG, completely uncontested.
It's a lot harder for OMG to tiptoe around. Lumao, maybe going to back away here. Doesn't actually want to force the fight just yet, because they can force the Baron first. Smite comes in, and that's going to be the objective taken. And now JDG forced the fight. Bullet time across a couple, but not doing too much for himself. Lumao walks away from the engage. Hacker wants to turn this into more, trying to get onto Lumao. He's actually just going to repel. Oh, turns into gold right in the middle of the air. Hacker flashes away. Yagao finishes the job, though. And Kurt's trying to zone away. There's nothing he can do. Cold is going to be the next target. So, so low. As Icon wants to do anything he can, but the answer is nothing. He's going to go down in just a couple of seconds, and it's another ace for JDG. These guys are team fighting gods.
Clean ace for JDG. They've got the wave in the bottom lane and the Baron buff to boot. They can now start to move in and clear out these turrets. I mean, with 15 seconds really before Hacker comes up, it's going to be so handy for them to get this inhibitor back away and spend all the gold they just picked up.
Yeah, fantastic situation for JDG here. They're going to grab this bottom lane inhibitor.
They're going for it.
I think they might be able to end the game right here. 20 seconds still on Icon. Important that he survived so long in that team fight. It actually turns into a negative for them. JDG trying to end the game right now. That's going to be both Nexus turrets going down. A beautiful insect onto SMLZ. Good night, Aphelios. 50% win rate, my friend, as the Nexus will fall. JDG start the season strong with a 2-0 on OMG.